Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. Anyway, we're here with this nasty oracle thing, which is a giant brain with tentacles and eyes all over the place. And it sees all through these mirrors. Pretty interesting. Got a train. A study. What is that? Is that a monkey? A troll or something? Someone's playing ball over here. Yeah, that's pretty interesting. I have no idea what's going on over here. The glinting mirrors. So we got mirrors and glinting mirrors. Let's look at the mirrors.
Thousands of lives are being reflected in each mirror. I really shouldn't look, but there's such a powerful allure in watching other people go about their daily business. The Oracle said that the stories repeat themselves again and again. I think that's because people don't really change. Different places, different people, the same mistakes.
Well, that's depressing. What about the glinting mirrors?
It's very difficult to recognize anything at all in this mirror. Perhaps it's showing a future in constant motion? Would I like to know when I'll die? And what is going to become of this one? No. I believe that not knowing what the future will bring is part of life.
Let's see if the Oracle has anything more to say.
Perhaps you could help me again.
Shh! This is getting exciting!
Perhaps you could help me again.
Shh!
Okay. We're done in here. We have to win this battle, this courtroom drama. Still can't get this key, huh?
I need the key if I'm going to free Critter and the other one.
Right.
Probably not a good strategy for me to just grab it and hope for the best. The head of Medusa's dangerous. The Oracle's quite right about that. I need the key if I'm going to free Critter. Critter'll be alright. Won't matter what the outcome. He's a clever cookie and he'll probably save Nate. The Oracle says that I won't be able to change the Archmage back without my friends. Got to be done, I guess. Hey, Judge! All defendants are entitled to a lawyer, are they not? I will be their lawyer.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Why not? Being the judge, I'm all for a fair trial. No one should be able to say, I sentenced them to death unjustly.
I don't know if I want to be represented by her.
Shut up, Nate. The accused is only allowed to talk when their lawyer tells them to.
Ha.
Well, what do you have to say in their defense?
Spelling error. I don't really don't want to doom him and make the game end. Well, I could just restore the game. Proven imbecile, Your Honor.
Proven imbecile, Your Honor. He is not compos mentis.
Oi!
Oi!
Try to steal from me. That's really bordering on madness.
And his IQ lies somewhere between that of a jelly glowfish and a cave troll.
Yeah.
I am not an imbecile, and I'm much smarter than a glow jellyfish.
Maybe a little smarter.
He stole the Mary without any idea of how to fly an airship.
And did he not promptly crash in the Northlands?
I didn't. You're both really enjoying this, aren't you?
The court acknowledges that he's an idiot. But that ain't enough to lessen the punishment.
Granted, but I would like idiot to be highlighted in the records.
Sustained.
You... now.
What else have you got?
He's a bad lot, through and through, Your Honor.
The deeds he's accused of are grave. But just like one can't accuse a troll of being insolent and smelly, one can't accuse Nate of objectionable behavior and being smelly.
Hey!
He's just of bad character through and through.
Can he give examples for the objectionable behavior, I mean? The bad smell is quite obvious.
Making advances towards women and promises of a life together and then leaving her without so much as a word.
It's going to come out here, isn't it?
In the middle of the night.
Certainly not sensitive, but in his defense, he is a pirate. What else do you have?
Well, we finally come down to this anyway. A higher power is responsible for his actions, Your Honor.
He is not responsible for his actions. He's being controlled by a higher power.
Oh, the voodoo doll defense.
Misspelling.
Not at all. There is a higher power which controls him and all of us, I think.
Yes.
Indeed. Behold the water jug.
Move the jar.
Oh, yeah. So impressive.
Wait.
But the Oracle said so.
I want to move the jar.
Oh, it would seem as if your higher power isn't cooperating, sweetie.
Let me go again. I want to see
Perhaps
what else I can do.
It was just not paying attention.
But there is the higher power.
But the Oracle said this higher power really exists.
Please don't tell me that's your defense strategy.
Just shut up! Look! At the water jug!
Nah, that was the win.
How'd you do that?
No, that was the higher power.
If so, then it could get that coconut down from that tree.
How are we going to do that?
That is impossible.
How is she doing this?
Indeed.
You, turn around. Now go ask your higher power how many fingers I'm holding up.
Three.
It is three fingers.
Wait, I'm the higher power.
Oh, that's witchcraft.
We're the higher
Someone's
power.
Someone's watching me. They want to control me. And they want to drive me crazy.
I don't got to control you yet.
But they won't get me.
You're out? Well, that works.
That was brilliant. How did you do that?
It's funny, it's a little door and the big doors.
You mean there really is a higher power controlling everything?
Hi.
That can't be.
No, huh?
Oh, higher power. If you are really there... Make a green unicorn appear.
I'd love to do that, actually.
See? Just a figment of imagination.
Wait, I want to do it.
Huh. All right, then. Release me.
See what else she has to say. Okay, it just makes her growl. Is she trying to do it with her, like, mind or something?
An old, slightly rusty key, which will open the stocks.
Rescue Critter first, and then we'll leave.
Critter doesn't need my help to get out of that thing.
Nope.
He's just there out of solidarity.
Ah. If we must.
Come on, Critter. We're going.
Don't I even get a thank you?
Not so fast.
I didn't ask for your help, and we would have managed fine on our own. Isn't that right, buddy?
No.
You see?
He said no. You are right. I should have just left you there.
Left you to rot in the stocks.
Maybe you should have. You're good at betraying your friends.
I have not betrayed anyone.
Critter, can you tell that person that the proof of her infidelity is clear enough for anyone to see?
Mm.
Critter, tell this excuse of a pirate that I was not unfaithful to him.
He was about to say something.
Even if I'd wanted to, I couldn't have been unfaithful to him. He left me.
Critter, tell her that I won't listen to this any longer.
Poor Critter.
Nate, it's about the Archmage and Wilbur.
What? What about them?
The Archmage has been cursed and Wilbur's wanted for murder.
That's nonsense. That little guy wouldn't hurt a fly.
We have to help them.
I can't.
You must.
I can drop you off in Elfburrow if you like.
That would be a start. The spark of life is there. My father has it.
Hmm. Yeah. Let's just go.
The minutes ahead.
Are you sure you'll be able to find the Elfburrow?
I guess the Red Pirate took the Medusa head in with him. Hey. Up close.
Right. Someone's going to have to go up to my father and ask him for the spark of life. Then we have to head off to find Lorem Ipsum. Hello?
Well, you can talk to your
own
father.
I'm not going to help. That's your problem.
Well, I'm not over the moon about it either, but the Oracle did say that I needed friends in order to overcome the challenges that lie ahead of me.
Then I suggest you look for some. Farewell.
But you have to help me. I can't possibly meet Mother in this state. The gods only know what she'd do to me.
And quite rightly, too.
Oh, yeah? Then why don't you tell him yourself that you're going to desert him?
Rabbit.
The frog?
That's Archmage Alistair. Didn't you listen to anything I said?
Well, she said he was cursed.
I'm sorry. I can't.
Why can't he?
Oi, Critter. Come on. Just look what she's done.
You can help your
Critter.
Friends. You're able to. Give me that. You can't.
Critter! I knew that you wouldn't desert me. And that's good. Mother must under no circumstances see me like this.
Critter's awesome. Uh-oh.
I was informed of your arrival, Ivo.
Oh, hello, Mother.
Oh, hello, Mother.
I've been worried, child.
Well, I'm so sorry about that. But perhaps you should have a lie down and we'll talk about everything in the morning.
What is the matter with you? Why don't you turn around?
I'm stuck. Why don't you turn around?
Why don't you turn around first?
The company of that human is not good for you. That is why I told him to go away.
You did what?
I know it was a mother. Well,
what have you?
Oops.
Well, I can explain.
Not necessary.
What'd she do? Oh, boy. Alright, I'm really mad at that lady right now. Put her to sleep and made tendrils come out and grab him.
Helping her? Why should I? Just turns up and what the hell is taking so long? Critter, come on, it's time to go.
Nah. Critter's stuck. Okay, we're in control of Nate again. Let's look at the cannon. Why not?
Last time I used this thing, I blew a bounty hunter out of the sky. Nonetheless, Critter and I prefer to avoid a fight if we can and rely on our brains and good looks.
Tch.
The Elfburrow is one of the most beautiful spots imaginable. But a golden prison is still a prison. The Elfburrow is but a...
So, my little hippogriff.
Ivo's hippogriff doesn't seem very happy. Perhaps she's missing her rider. Or she's just hungry. Or both. Go over into the garden. There are plants and fruit there if you're hungry. Don't fancy greens, huh? Go over into the garden. Don't fancy... The Elfburrow is one of the most beautiful spots imaginable. But a golden prison...
The wheel.
As soon as I've picked up Critter, I'm out of here. Perhaps we'll fly to... Ah, whatever. We're free. We can fly to wherever we want. As soon as I've picked up... Perhaps...
Wooden plank?
Mary was damaged recently, and I want to repair her. When I say recently, I mean about 2 years ago. But in my defense, I had to save the world in the meantime.
Whatever. Just take the plank.
I'll start the repairs tomorrow. But what can you do if there's a better use for the plank?
I have no idea what we can use a plank for.
A heavy plank of wood. Not very long, but quite fat. Just like the Mary.
Well, she'd love to hear that. A cage.
When the Mary belonged to the Red Pirate, he didn't just use her for pleasure trips. They did some work now and again, as this cage proves.
What kind of work?
One of my goals in life is to never be a prisoner in my own cage again.
Steam engine?
Some gnome engineers wanted to fine-tune Mary in appreciation of our victory against Mortroga. But Mary doesn't like gadgets, and I'm happy with her the way she is. When I first got the Mary, I understood absolutely nothing about her mechanics. Now I understand at least twice as much.
Twice as much as nothing? Oh, wait. Oh.
Critter!
I wanted to look at the ship.
What have you done now?
Mama looks evil!
Ivo's mother? Oh. Come on, let's get you out of there
first. He's changed colors.
All right. Darn elven magic. Yes, I'll get help. Wait here.
Futsuluka.
Damn elven magic. Hey, Critter, can't you somehow slip out of there? You can usually squeeze through most gaps.
That's what I was thinking.
The thorns, I see.
Hmm.
There's got to be a way. All right. It was worth a try.
Did we hurt him?
Damn elven magic. Hey, Critter. The thorn.
I wasn't done on the Mary, by the way. Oh, I thought it said look at the ship. It says leave the ship. Okay, what else can we do? Leave the ship. Look at the rope. That's what I want to do.
The Mary tried to teach me some knots. I think she likes passing on her knowledge to me. She said she'll try and teach pigs to fly next.
Whatever. Take the rope. Okay, we can't take it. We could just throw it overboard. Alright, let's throw it overboard.
I don't need to moor the Mary. She holds her position herself.
So what are we supposed to do with the rope? We can't just take it? Use the rope with the hippogriff. The wheel. Alright. Let's go down. Lots of stuff to look at again. Oven.
The Mary consumes huge amounts of coal. For the oven, but primarily for the steam engine. The Miners Guild promised to give me free coal for the Mary for the rest of my life at the end of the war. When I reminded them, a rather grim-faced dwarf said that the whole thing was meant to be symbolic. Many promises were made in the rush of victory and later not kept.
Hi, the wardrobe?
The Red Pirate kept asking me again and again about his costumes when I was drinking with him. I didn't have the heart to tell him we used some of them as oil rags.
Yeah. Search.
Hmm. A sailor's uniform with a hat and a duck beak made of card. Nope. They're not going to help me in the current situation.
Hmm.
A rabbit costume with a fluffy tail and ears to match. I'd have liked to have seen Ivo in that. Unfortunately, the critter never wanted to hand it over.
The critter?
A purple tentacle costume. It's critters, not the red pirates. Critter claimed it was actually useful once.
Yeah, you used it to disguise him as Tentacle in the Critter Chronicles.
It's hard to believe, but a whole cupboard full of costumes isn't going to help me at the moment.
Probably not.
It's hard to believe.
Let's look at the meal box.
Provisions are low. If we sail around much longer, we'll have to get supplies from somewhere, or Critter will have to eat less.
Critter, what about you?
Tinned peaches. Oh, empty.
Oh,
it's
water.
Hard to believe.
Wait. Empty tin cans.
Metal cans. The dwarves invented them to keep perishable foods fresh for longer.
So I've got a wooden plank and metal cans. Very interesting, like, useful stuff here. Let's look at the writing desk.
Ivo tidied up here when we flew back from the wildlands. At least that's what she called it. In reality, all she did was bring confusing order to my orderly disorder.
Your orderly disorder?
Navigation isn't a complicated science. I choose a place on the map I'd like to fly to, and I tell the Mary the name of the place, and she flies me there. I don't know why other people find it so difficult.
They're more like doing it manually. Set a course?
I'm not flying off without Critter. Critter is my first mate, and the cook, and the lookout, and he shovels coal and helps me annoy the Mary. He's indispensable. I'm not flying off without Critter. Critter is my first mate.
Let's look at the chest.
A pile of maps, diaries, travelogues and stuff. I was looking for things that promise eternal life. The Holy Grail, the Philosopher's Stone, the Fountain of Youth, that kind of thing. Harder to find than you'd think. That's why I had the idea with the djinn. At least I knew where to look for him. Wasn't there a book on Lorem Ipsum here? That's it. Perhaps I can give it to Ivo before I leave.
That's what we need, right?
A notebook with some notes on the lost city of Lorem Ipsum. Perhaps I can give it to Ivo before I leave.
Maybe you should stop leaving. Dressing table?
I've seen alchemic lab benches and building sites with less stuff than this dressing table. Perfume atomizers, face powder, makeup? Nothing of any use at the moment. Perfume atom...
dressing table... Mirror.
People always think that pirates don't care about their appearance. But that's not true. We're just as sensitive as everyone else when it comes to what we look like. You finally managed to get a good beard going. Then people say you looked better without.
Nah. Yeah. Nate problems. Look at the Mary. She's the last thing here.
Mary and me like a bit of banter. She says I haven't got a clue about flying airships, and that we only stay in the air because she ignores my commands. Ha!
Oh, I can hear her say it now.
Hey, Mary.
Captain Nate?
What course have you set, Mary?
What's our course, helmsman? Woman? Ship?
We are at anchor in the harbor and don't have a course.
Oh, play along. You know I like all that nautical stuff.
Course set 2456 degrees north-south, Captain.
Very good. Keep course.
Yes, sir, Captain.
All right. Let me know if there's a problem.
And then?
And then?
most of the communication between a captain and his ship's nonverbal. We'll leave it at that for now.
Huh.
Most...
Alright, so that's it. Alright, let's leave again. Let's check over here. We got flowers. Oh, that one's sad again.
I've never been very interested.
Oh, it's been removed.
But there are things in this garden I've never seen anywhere
else. The other plant's been taken out.
Those two plants there, for example. It looks as though they're strangling one another.
Oh, there's two? I couldn't tell. I thought there was one here and one there. Never mind. Bee's nest?
Critter attacked this beehive one night. He claims to this day that it was the sweetest triumph of his life.
What?
But it was 3 days before the swelling from the bee stings went down.
Why is that the biggest triumph of his life? Ball of string, oh.
No trace of Arbor, but he left this ball of string lying here. Perhaps he was going to tie up bushes with it or something. Eh, Shorty won't mind, I think.
Hmm.
A ball of sturdy string. A couple of feet should do.
Just want to see something. No, there's nothing I can do with any of this stuff. Okay. Okay, so that doesn't work getting him out. Weeping willow.
That's strange. When I was here last, that tree looked a lot happier.
Yeah, we had to change it. We had to do something with that, I forgot. Okay, let's go this way. Monster.
Critter claims he doesn't know Ollie, but the family resemblance can't be denied.
That's the monster's name, Ollie?
Ollie used to be a bookmaker. Got involved with the wrong people. Ivo says I just make all this up.
Probably do. Dragon's head? This one have a name too?
I only had dealings with a dragon once. The dear thing wasn't really all there, and completely harmless.
Right.
I've never really understood why it's all right to cut off dragons' heads. Dragons are rational beings, not a nice tradition.
Can we look at the Rubik's Cube? No. Let's look at these swords. There's Cloud Sword from Final Fantasy VII.
According to Ivo, these are swords belonging to some of those who have tried to conquer the Woodland Realm. Nowadays, everyone knows it's better not to pick a fight with elves.
Change it to the Minecraft one. There you go. Books.
During my time here, I sat in this library many times enjoying a good book. Not.
Mm.
During my time. Not.
Yeah. Okay. We've got a top hat over here.
The king and queen keep gifts given to them by delegations from far-off lands in this room. Some of them are rather bizarre. The top hat might have been a present from a kobold delegation.
Hmm.
Although, it's a bit too big for that.
A kobold delegation?
The top hat.
What's the other thing we have to look at? These blooms. Come on, walk all the way over.
I nearly got arrested once because of a flower like that. I didn't know why they're forbidden almost everywhere. Until I heard someone playing one for the first time.
Oh, yeah. All right. Shall we go up into Ivo's room?
I have to be careful. If the queen catches me, there'll be no leniency.
Couldn't imagine there would be.
I couldn't allow him to propose to you. What sort of life would you have?
A happy one?
You'd have lost him so soon, maybe just 50 years after marrying him. Or were you planning to go into the world with him and get old just like him? That would be terrible, and I told him as much. If one truly loves someone, then it's sometimes better to let them go. You know that I can be very convincing. The human spirit is weak. And perhaps there was a tiny bit of magic involved.
Maybe you should follow your own
logic, lady. Too late.
And since you love her, let her go.
That darn witch! It all sounded so right.
That's not
though. I was already across the sea when it became clear to me that I might have made the biggest mistake of my life. No wonder Ivo hates me. Her mother must never have told her what happened, or she blamed me for everything.
Or both.
What I'd really like to do is go up there, give the old boot a slap round the face, and get Ivo out of this place.
Sounds good to me.
But Ivo's mother is a powerful priestess. She's probably got a dozen ways she could incapacitate me without me even noticing. I have to be careful.
Well, I'm going to leave us at this precarious position. Still got stuff we can look at. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. And a bang, bang, boogie. And don't stop the boogie.